Oh shit, speakers. Oh shit. Hey guys, Sam and Tavavo here, and in this episode of Kerbal Drone Program, we attempt to go to the moon, and we also attempt to build a plane. I failed the attempt to build a plane, just so you guys know. So here's some footage of me failing to build a plane. It's kind of interesting, I reckon. As you can see, I attempted to make a small kind of jet plane. But propeller planes and biplanes have been the king in this series, because the Juno jet is weak, to say the least, and the biplane wings kind of work the best in this, because the ailerons and stuff... Oh, I forgot to put ailerons on them. That might be why it didn't work. Alright, here's the lunar mission that we are doing. As you can see, we're trying to go to the moon. Now, the big thing about going to the moon in Kerbal Space Program... Just to repeat that, so to go to the moon in KSP, you're going to need a lot of delta V, so you're going to need a lot of velocity. You're going to need about 2,500 delta V to just get to the moon, another 300 to 500 to get into an orbit around the moon, and then if you want to get back, it'll be another 500, and I kind of messed up here, guys. I failed to get into a stable orbit on the first orbit, so I just kind of went through the atmosphere and decided to see what would happen. Alright, it's at this point where I make the maneuver node to go to the moon. And I also reposition the craft, and then cool shot of Kerbin. And yes, this is working. It was at that point where I made the maneuver, and we knew we were going to the moon. So, as you can see, this is the journey to the moon, sped up in 10 times, because why not? And it was at that moment that I realized that I was heading straight for the moon, so I created a maneuver node to get me into an orbit around the moon, so that we can collect some nice, juicy science. We're going to use that for something soon. Don't know what, but I know it'll be something. I mean, most things are something, though. Another great thing about this mission is that it's kind of the first time we're going to try to get to the moon and probably do it successfully. So we entered the orbit around the moon, which is very nice. And I just did some science, got about 40 science from that, which is very, very nice. And let's just have a look at this. So it was around this point where I realized that I didn't want to stay in lunar orbit. The craft was now useless to me. So I decided that, why the hell not, I'm going to get it out of lunar orbit, and I am going to crash it into the planet. Or land it into the planet. The landing didn't work out that much. As you can see, I'm just trying to keep my velocity kind of down. And we are slowly going down towards the surface. And I'm slowly burning so that I can get my speed a bit down so that I can land. Made the attack angle a bit deeper, and it was about this moment I knew that I kind of screwed it up a bit. Then the retrograde, it kind of messed up, and it got that like that, and then this happened. Not too proud of this. So yeah. Oh no, we just did a skid on the ground. Okay, we did a skid. So I decided to get some data here. As you can see, the antennas. Somehow still working, but the solar panels are gone, so that craft is kind of dead now. I mean, it'll be on the moon for a while it slowly drains its battery. Maybe I'll put it in hibernation mode. Yeah, I'll do that. You know, so it can last a bit longer. And then I have to quit. So everybody, have a nice day. This has been SnakeMan250 signing off.